Yeah, hi. We are from SVS Embedded. The project title name is called Google Map Based Underground Cable Fault Detection over Internet or Underground Cable Fault Detection over IoT. So in this project, I'm using an 8089S52 microcontroller we are using, and we are using four total 9 keys RL1, RL1, RL2, RL3 for the red cable. GL1, GL2, GL3 for the green cable, YL1, YL2, YL3 for the yellow cable. So if there is any fault, so we are capturing the latitude, longitude from the cell phone, latitude, longitude from the global positioning system called GPS. Here we are using VK16E module we are using. So the GPS, we are continuously monitoring the global positioning system data. And here we are using one GPRS modem. We are using SIM800L quad band modem, 850 MHz to 1800 MHz frequency. Here we are using one Idea SIM card. With that SIM card, we are enabling the internet. So all the data should be displayed on the LCD, 16x2 LCD display. If there is any fault, the data should be displayed on the LCD, and we are capturing the latitude longitude data, and we are updated onto our page. So here we are using one web page that is IoT based underground cable fault detection. Okay, so with that page, every 30 seconds the page will be refreshed. So here the present data, date and time. So now today date is 15. Okay, and don't press clear data, all the data will be erased. So this is the data, the MySQL database. With the database, IoT based underground cable fault detection, lat value, long value, present date and time. Okay, so let us coming into the hardware part. So here we are using 230 input step down transformer, 9 volts output AC. So here we are giving to the bridge rectifier, filter capacitor, 7805 regulator and one LED. So this entire section is called power supply section, and this is reset button. If the program is stuck, we need to restart this. And here we are using one crystal that is 11.0592 MHz crystal. Crystal is the heart of the circuit for the controller to generate the clock pulses to the internal CPU. And here we are using one 8089S52 microcontroller. It's an 8-bit microcontroller, and it is port 0. It is connected to the 16x2 LCD display. Port P1.0, 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, 1 cap 0, 1 cap 1, 1 cap 2, like that, 1 cap 3, 1 cap 4, 1 cap 5, 3 cap 0, 3 cap 4, 5, 6. Those are connected to the microcontroller data line pin. P2.7, it is connected to the relay 1. P2.6, relay 2. P2.5, it is connected to the another relay coil. Red fault, green fault, yellow fault. If there is any fault, the indication should be shown. And same time, we are using one GPS module. With that GPS module, we are using one bridge rectifier, filter capacitor, 7805 regulator and one LED, and one max 232 IC, and this is GPS modem, and the data will be sending to RS232 cable, and it is given to the max 232 IC, and the data will be coming here. And we are using another module, that is GSM module. Here also we are using one bridge rectifier, filter capacitor, LM317 adjustable voltage regulator and one LED. Now I'm going to start the kit. Okay, now I'm giving the power supply to the first GSM module. Already it is given the GPS module. Why? Because the green LED should be starts. When the green LED will be starts, we are getting the latitude longitude. If green LED is not blinking, this GPS module is not taking the latitude longitude from the satellite. Okay, so here you know about that, like whenever the blinking LED will be stops, we will get the cell phone tower signal. Okay, now it got the signal. Now I'm going to give the main power supply board. Okay, display of underground cable fault distance over internet IoT. So wait for 2 seconds. Whatever the settings of GPRS settings, the settings will be sending to the GSM module. Once the settings will be enabled, the blinking LED, the signal LED continuously blinking starts. Once the GPRS will ready, GPRS modem is ready, so we will go for the faults. Okay, HTTP starts. Yeah, GPRS is ready. The blinking also continuously starts. RL1 okay, RL2 okay, RL3 okay. GL1, GL2, GL3. Okay, YL1, YL2, YL3. Suppose if second line is fault, means this should be fault. So okay, once all the cables should be, if RL2 is fault, okay, once the fault is occurred, distance at 2 kilometer, this is 1 kilometer, 2 kilometer, 3 kilometer, like that, 1 2 3 1 2 3. So it captured the latitude longitude and it pushing the data to the HTTP. So this is, we are getting the latitude value, longitude value from the GPS position, and it is sending the data. So there should be one commands, HTTP hypertext transfer protocol with action completed, then it will tell you that HTTP okay, like GPRS sent. Once the GPRS will be sent, we can see the data onto the map, and we will get the SMS alert with the 2 mobile numbers where the fault is occurred. So actually it is sending more commands to the GPRS, but we are stopped at the latitude longitude only. After that some time it will tell you that I send the data, GPRS is sent. Okay, once GPRS sent, then it will go for the sending SMS to the two persons, one for student and another for me only. Okay, so this means we need to stop, otherwise it will continuously send the data to the server, so our data will be lost. Okay, so SMS sent, sending SMS to, so this mobile number will receive the SMS alert. SMS sent. Okay, I got the SMS. Okay, so if view, okay, red cable fault. Okay, in that there is no internet, Wi-Fi is on. Okay, so red LED is off, also off. Okay, so system date and time. Three ten. So the data is updated. Okay, and we can monitoring the data. So here I think maybe 10. So every 30 seconds the page will be updated. So 3:10 we got the fault at RL2. Okay, so we are also got the SMS alert and we can view the data, RL2, the cable is fault. Okay, so like that, up to 9 data will be updated, individual data, individual SMS, RL, so here GL2, okay, GL1 is fault, 1 kilometer distance. Okay, GPRS sent. GPRS sent. Sending SMS 1. Student mobile number. Sending SMS 1. SMS sent. Okay. So second is sending SMS 2. This mobile number will receive the SMS alert. SMS sent. Yeah, I received the SMS, green cable fault, distance at 1 kilometer, view. Okay, view. Okay, so its data should be updated. Okay, GL2. So after everything is okay, every line is okay, yeah, relay is also off, and we can see, check the data. Okay, 313, this is 24 hours, 313 latitude value, longitude value. Okay, and thinking, so here present date and time should be updated. 313. And thanking you. If there is any doubt, let me know to SVS Embedded.